Hi everyone, it's a new week for a video. Right now I'm definitely not in the best mood to make a video, but I need to because a lot happened last week, and yeah, so let's get started. Last Monday at school I did a presentation about school in America. This was my second one that I've done. And honestly, I love doing speeches and presentations about school in America because I love to show off how amazing school in America is. Tuesday, we got to look at our final grades for the semester, and they mark it so weird. I'm usually used to just an A, B, C, or D. And they're on numbers, and the highest you can have is a 20. I had a 10.9 out of 20, which is barely making 50%, but I am very proud of myself because it's difficult learning everything in school in a different language. And some of my friends have lower marks than me, which... that just, I don't know. It makes me happy because I'm doing better than some French people. But then also, you have to kind of look at their effort that they're putting in, because my friends that have lower grades than me definitely can do way better than what they're doing. So that's kind of the reality of actually knowing that they're capable of doing better, but they're just not showing it. But I don't care. My grade is good for me. It's very stressful because my grades have to transfer to the United States, and that's either if you like get electives for the class or not. And it's super stressful because in the future I want to go to really nice colleges. And who knows if, like, they see those grades that I've had in France and they don't accept me. But I'm talking to my counselor back at home, my school counselor, to help me, like, understand maybe what are the possibilities of colleges maybe looking past it, or how I could tell them that it's because I was in France, I didn't know the language at all, so... literally, I thought this would be the year of stress-free, but it's definitely not. I'm stressing out so much about school and about my grades, and it's just unnecessary stress that I need to have on my exchange. Another thing about the grades is literally teachers here, I'm sorry to say like this, but teachers here grade your papers like Nazis. They have to find at least one thing wrong with your paper or with your grades. It's unbelievable. There was this girl in my Francais class, and they had to go up on the board and like write down like their homework or whatever. And so the teacher was like grading it, and she got every single one right. The teacher wrote something down in French and then gave her a 5.5 out of 10. What? You just marked all of her answers right and then you give her a 5 out of 10. I do not understand it. It is ridiculous. It makes me so mad and so frustrated because they grade like you're in college. Like, you're not in college. You're in high school. Like, give us a break. Like, we're learning. Like, ugh, I could go on and on about this. It makes me super mad. And honestly, I hate going to school because of how bad they, how hard they grade you, because that affects how we feel. I honestly hate getting tests back because of my grades and of my marks that I'll get. I know that I'll get terrible marks, and that only makes my mood just even worse. So anyways, the rest of the days, I just went to school again, and then I had volleyball Wednesday. And then finally Saturday came, and I got to see all my exchange friends. I was so excited. We went to Colmar, and we went to some Christmas markets, and then after that, we did ice skating. I think I ice skated for maybe 10 minutes and then left the ice skating rink because, one, my feet were freezing, and two, I was freezing. It was so cold there. They told us that we were going to have a surprise, and the surprise was District 1670, I believe. So we got to meet another district, which was a ton of fun. It's so nice to meet other exchange students, especially from the U.S. And when we got there, they're all like, oh my gosh, there's like 10 Americans at this district. And it was so funny because we do have a lot of Americans in my district, and they only had maybe 4. So it was really nice to talk to them. And the funny thing is, one of the guys came up to me and was like, you look kind of familiar. I'm like, really? He's like, do you like do like vlogs on YouTube? And I'm like, yes. He's like, I saw one of them. And it's just crazy how other people look at my videos. And I don't know, he complimented it, so obviously I'm doing something right with these, so is that just made my night to know that other people are watching my videos, and he's never met me before, so it's very cool and exciting for me that that happened. And then Sunday, we woke up, went on a nature walk in a field. Yeah, we got back, and then I'm still tired. We got back, we said our goodbyes to the other district, and then we went to the train station. I was unbelievably tired. It was terrible. I almost fell asleep on the train, but I knew that I couldn't because I'd missed my stop. Once I got home, we set up Christmas and the Christmas tree, and I don't know, that last night just made me super excited for Christmas. I'm so happy that I could spend Christmas with this family because they're amazing. They're funny. I can just joke around with them, and oh, they make my exchange amazing already. So I'm very thankful for them. That is the end of this video. It's definitely not very detailed, but I'm very tired and very stressed out. That is why I'm not in the mood really for this video. It's because of these stupid grades and all this stressing out that I'm doing that's honestly pointless, but I stress out about everything. So I will talk to you all Sunday on time, not Monday. I will make sure it is Sunday and tell you all about my amazing week that I'm going to have. Have a wonderful week. I miss all of you guys back home. My mom is sending a package today, so you need to call her ASAP if you want to send me a letter or anything super small because my package is already full. So call my mom. If you don't have her number, message me on Facebook. Go fast now. Bye. Jour 1, amour numéro 1, c'est l'amour suprême. Dis-moi que tu m'aimes. Je veux un jour numéro 2, une suite à l'hôtel, supplément mortel. Je t'ai regardé toute la nuit. Danser sur mon âme n'est plus permis. 9 jours, la vie c'est du velours. Et l'éternité, une nécessité.
jour 10, variation du délice. Que voudrais-tu faire? Une balade.